Hello everyone, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, based on which time zone you are in across the world. This is Sumit Agarwal and I'm very excited on my master's journey, MBA in strategic management with University of North Texas. I have 20 years of professional experience working in various roles, both on the IT and the business side for multiple industry verticals and held various leadership roles during this journey. I'm in my first semester of MBA and got an opportunity to read this book titled On Becoming a Leader, authored by Warren Bennis. I would like to review this book with all of you today, emphasizing on what the author wrote on leadership, as well as we'll try to bring in perspective based on experiences from my professional and personal life. Let's start with author Mr. Bennis. Bennis was the youngest Army lieutenant to serve in Europe during World War II and learned his first leadership lessons on the battlefield. Bennis mentored CEOs, trained countless soon-to-be leaders while teaching at Harvard, MIT, and USC, and advised US presidents John F. Kennedy, Lyndon Johnson, Gerald Ford, and Ronald Reagan. He authored 30 books and served on a multitude of high-level advisory boards, including the White House Task Force. Bennis was known as the Dean of Leadership Gurus by Forbes magazine. On Becoming a Leader has been one of the most amazing reads. It is about how we can make leadership a personal habit. Warren Bennis connects with you by making you reflect upon yourself as a human being and a leader. He gives many examples of great leaders and explains in depth the reasons behind their successes. In this review, I will highlight some important traits that according to Warren Bennis are must to have in a leader. This book was being praised by Al Gore and has been published in 13 languages. Let's get into the book and deep dive. What do we learn after reading this great masterpiece? Becoming a leader is synonymous with becoming yourself. It's precisely that simple, and it's also that difficult. He talks about mastering the context. To lead effectively, a leader must make decisions based on the big picture and not on current circumstances. Bennis uses the example of television writer-producer Norman Lear, who revolutionized American television by making shows such as All in the Family and Cagney and Lacey. For the first time, TV shows reflected real American people rather than cowboys, private eyes, and caricatured families. Lear saw a world that was waiting to be expressed and expressed it. Not only did his shows break the mold, they were successful year after year. By having faith in his own vision and confidence in his ideas, Lear created cutting-edge sitcoms that featured topics and situations that broke new ground. Next thing Bennis talks about, understanding the basics. There are some basic ingredients for becoming a leader. These are not traits that leaders are born with, but skills that are developed through years of experience and learning. These are the must-haves for effective leaders: a guiding vision, passion, self-knowledge, candor, maturity, trust, curiosity, daring. He talks about knowing yourself. A leader is self-aware. The leader never lies to himself, especially about himself, knows his flaws as well as his assets, and deals with them directly. We are our own best teachers if we accept the responsibility of educating ourselves. Bennis explains that we are capable of learning just about anything, and that learning involves reflecting on our own experiences. A leader who knows his strengths and limitations has the confidence to become a leader. Knowing the world, knowing how the world we live in affects our decisions is critical. We learn about the world through our experiences and our mistakes. We learn about the world from from mentors, books, and formal education. But it's not just the knowledge we accumulate that helps us. It's the commitment to learning for the sake of learning that helps us understand a world that keeps changing. Operating on instinct, at a certain point, leaders must learn to trust their intuition. Whether we call it the inner voice or just a gut feeling, that instinct is the accumulation of knowledge and experience and definitely worth listening to. Deploying yourself is strike hard, try everything. Curiosity and risk-taking makes a leader. The leader wonders about everything, wants to learn as much as he or she can, is willing to take risks, experiment, try new things. He doesn't worry about failure, but embraces errors, knowing he will learn from them. Leadership skills can't grow stronger unless we put them to the test over and over. Every leader fails. The best leaders learn to use failure as a chance to try a new approach. The point is to accept failure as part of the process and learn to face the situations we fear by learning new skills. Moving through the chaos, the true test of a leader is knowing how to lead when everything is falling apart. Leading in chaotic situations requires a leader that is willing to accept change as inevitable. Managing that change requires adaptability, flexibility, and patience, all while keeping the focus on the overall vision. Getting people on your side. Leading means deeply affecting others. A leader is not simply someone who experiences the personal exhilaration of being in charge. A leader is someone whose actions have the most profound consequences on other people's lives, for better or for worse, sometimes forever and ever. The only way to get people to follow is to gain their trust. Organizations can help or hinder. To become a leader, the constraints of the organization must not stop a leader from leading, whether it's bureaucratic red tape from above or lack of interest or commitment from below. Leaders stay the course. They continue to lead with the skills they have learned, believing in their effectiveness. Forging the future. A leader sees the big picture. Leaders do much more than lead others. They know how to innovate to keep their organization competitive. They promote effective communication at all levels and create strategic alliances. Leaders know how to tie it all together and lead their followers and their organization into a brighter future. Consider, for instance, the internal motto of internet retailer Amazon.com: work hard, play hard, change the world. In Bennis's assessment of American presidents, Lincoln was perhaps the greatest president because he focused on what at the time seemed only small possibilities, ending slavery and preserving the Union. His deep personal depression were nothing put next to those mighty causes. The final word: Bennis has probably done as much as anyone to shatter the myth of leaders as heroes, born, not made. We live in a democracy of leadership now, in which everyone can lead in some way. To become a leader is to claim the power and assurance that comes from being a one-off. I'm able to relate each and every concept of what Bennis has told in correlation with what I have studied in leadership research and development course as part of MBA curriculum. All leadership theories which are presented in the textbook Leadership in Organization by You are linked to traits which Bennis has mentioned in his book with examples. I would also like to talk about one of the current times leader, Mr. Narendra Modi, who is serving for last 7 years as the Prime Minister of India, the second most populous country and the largest democracy in the world. Various presses reported that PM Modi's bold leadership style is laying the foundation of New India. As an administrator, PM Modi has never shied away from tackling big problems. Big, bold, and innovative. These words sum up his approach to the administrative problems he has faced. Economic reforms, big ones, have occurred on a daily basis. PM Modi has dared to take decisions that might have the potential to cause friction in the short term only because he knows that they will help the nation in the long term. Clearly, national interest and foresight underline PM Modi's boldness to tackle big problems head on. This big vision of India also gets reflected in its grand ambition of Make in India. Another great example is the way India managed their COVID vaccination drive. They administered 25 million doses of COVID vaccine in a day. That's a world record. To put it in perspective, this is equivalent to the entire population of Australia. The way India was able to manage the whole vaccination drive, ensuring the entire process is seamless, digitable, and verifiable, is commendable and testimony of Modi's leadership. I've said a lot and hope you were able to get at least a glimpse of some of the important aspects of leadership. Do read this book and feel free to leave your comments and feedback. Just to end, I would like to call out, leaders manage the dream by communicating a vision, recruiting carefully, rewarding, retraining, and reorganizing. Thank you.